My name is Jonathan Kurman. I'm the director of interventional pulmonology at a large academic medical center in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. When you think about single-use bronchoscopes and interventional pulmonology, they really haven't been associated with each other historically. But the latest generation of single-use bronchoscopes is trying to change that. The goal of this study was to scientifically compare the main single-use flexible bronchoscopes that are out there on the market with the gold standard reusable flexible bronchoscope to determine if the single-use flexible bronchoscopes are as good or even better, and in which categories which scope excelled. So we identified different categories that were relevant to interventional pulmonologists, and we did the same tasks in the same models with each different type of scope to scientifically compare them. For example, when we were evaluating flexion and extension, we were doing so with different tools that we would typically use during an interventional pulmonology case. Things like endobronchial valves, dilation balloons, large forceps, small forceps, cryotherapy catheters, etc. So we try to make our evaluation as clinically relevant for the interventional pulmonologist and advanced bronchoscopist as possible. And what we saw was that in every single category, at least one single-use flexible bronchoscope was equivalent to or superior to the gold standard reusable flexible bronchoscope. And when we looked at the data in a more granular manner, we saw that the Ambu A5 scope was actually equivalent to or superior to the reusable flexible bronchoscope in the most number of categories. There was not one single-use bronchoscope that was perfect in every category. So there's still work to be done, but we've come such a long way. At this point, I've had the opportunity to use the Ambu aScope 5 for a variety of different interventional pulmonology cases. The Ambu aScope 5 lived up to my expectations. I realized the same benefits in terms of improved flexion and extension. It handled really well, great maneuverability. I was able to access all of the airways that I wanted to, which is not always the case when you're using a reusable flexible bronchoscope. I've used it more for endobronchial valve cases than for any other type of case. And in those cases in particular, where you need the ability to access challenging airways like apical segments or superior segments easily, the A5 let me do that with more control and precision and just confidence than I had been able to previously. For me, it was really a game changer in the bronchoscopy suite for those kinds of cases, so much so that the A5 has really become my default when I'm doing endobronchial valve cases. It just makes my life as an interventional pulmonologist easier.